microbiology by Santosh Mapte. Friends, today we are going to start the topic from molecular biology. And in today's topic, we will see about the gene expression. So friends, if you are watching these videos and if you have not subscribed this channel, so please subscribe this channel so that you will get notifications of upcoming videos. And at the same time, if you are new to this microbiology by Santosh Mapte, so I request you to subscribe this microbiology by Santosh Mapte so that you will get notifications of these upcoming videos. Now friends, today we are going to start here that topics from the molecular biology, and the name of that topic is gene expression. So before going further, I will like to tell you, dear friends, what is meant by this gene expression. Now all of you know that our body or every living organism, they have cells, and at the same time they have the genetic material in the form of DNA, and in case of some viruses, the genetic material is RNA. So whatever that genes are present in DNA molecule, now each gene, it has the specific function. So gene expression means, for example, in our cell or in our body, there is an insulin producing gene is present, and the main function of that insulin producing gene is to produce, once that gene get activated, then it will produces that insulin hormone which controls which regulate the blood sugar level. So here, whenever there is a need of insulin, after the increasing level of blood sugar, that gene get activated or that gene get transcribed and translated, and that insulin hormone is formed. It means that insulin producing gene get expressed, or there is an expression of that insulin producing gene. If you will take another example, for example, that is metabolism of lactose sugar by a bacterium. So whenever there is a lactose is present in nutrient medium, at that time the genes which are responsible for the metabolism of lactose, that gene get activated and they produces enzyme. And these enzymes later on, they metabolize that lactose. So it means there is an expression of these lactose metabolizing genes takes place. So that is called as the gene expression. Now the most important thing is here, whatever that gene expression is taking place, it is a multi-step process. It means it involves many steps here, but basically we are going to study about how the information which is stored in that gene or in that DNA molecule, first that information get copied into mRNA molecule or messenger RNA molecule, and then later on the information now copied in messenger RNA molecule, that information, or according to that information, there is a formation of protein which later on carry out its function in the cell or in the body. So this second step, it is called as translation. That is nothing but there is a gene expression takes place here. So in this topic here, now whatever that genetic information, it get copied into mRNA molecule, that is present in the form of genetic code. So here we are going to see about the genetic code. So that is our today's lecture, that is about the genetic code. We will see that properties, what is meant by genetic code, and what are the properties of this genetic code. So let's start here, that is about the genetic code, or what is meant by that genetic code. So friends, here it is the flow of genetic information. It means, so whatever this flow of genetic information is here, so how that flow of this genetic information takes place in any living organism. So if you see now all of you know that whatever that genes are present, these are present on this DNA molecule. So this is the double-stranded DNA molecule, and it consists of many genes which have a specific function. So this flow of genetic information or that gene expression, it involves two steps. one is the transcription and another one is the translation. So here, but basically this DNA molecule, it get replicated. It means this DNA molecule makes its own copies which are similar to that parent DNA molecule. So that daughter DNA molecules which are formed here by a process, and that process is called as replication process. So that's why here it is shown. So this DNA molecule, it get replicated, and that same copies of that parent DNA molecules are formed here. Okay, but when there is a gene expression is there, at that time whatever that genetic information is stored in this DNA molecule, so that genetic information, first it is copied into a single stranded mRNA molecule. So this is called as messenger RNA, and this process of copying of this genetic information from DNA to RNA molecule or messenger RNA molecule, this process, it is called as transcription process. And later on, so here now the next process is here. So the after that, now whatever that information it is copied in RNA molecule, according to that information, now this information which is copied in this RNA molecule, it is present in the form of genetic code, and according to that genetic code, that information get translated, and there is a formation of functional proteins here, and later on they carry out that particular function in the cell or in the body. Okay, so this is about the two-step process of this flow of genetic information, and which involves number one, transcription, which means copying of information present in DNA molecule into messenger RNA molecule, and formation of this protein molecule according to the that genetic information present in RNA molecule in the form of genetic code. So that process is called as translation. So these are the two steps of the gene expression. One is transcription, another one is translation. And collectively, these two step processes, it is, that is transcription and translation, it is called as central dogma of molecular biology. So it is, this is known as the central dogma of molecular biology. So hope you have understood this, what is meant by gene expression and what is meant by this central dogma of molecular biology, and that is actually a basis of this gene expression. So next we will see, that is about the introduction. So see, this is the structure of mRNA molecule or messenger RNA molecule. Now here this is 5 prime end and this is 3 prime end. This is the single stranded mRNA molecule, and it has these nitrogen bases, or we can see here nucleotides present on that messenger RNA molecule. So this is the nucleotide consisting of uracil, then nucleotide consisting of cytosine, nucleotide consisting of guanosine. So these are the nucleotides present on this mRNA molecule. Now that whatever that information, now it is stored in the form of code, or which is called as genetic code, and there is a formation of codons on this mRNA molecule. So codons means here it is a combination of three nucleotides. So we can see here this UCZ, this is one codon, then CUA, this is another codon, then AAG, this is another codon, then CZU, this is another codon, and GGA, this is another codon. And here, so whatever the structure is here, it is known as transfer RNA, or it is called as tRNA. So this is known as the anticodon. Why it is anticodon? Because the sequence of nucleotides present on mRNA molecule, it is called as codon. So this is one codon here, and which has the nucleotides CZU. So against of this sequence, because the complementary sequence for or nucleotide for cytosine is, it is guanosine. Okay, the complementary that base or nucleotide for this G containing nucleotide, it is cytosine containing nucleotide, and same is here, that is that nucleotide which has the uracil, and the complementary nucleotide for this uracil containing that nucleotide, it is nothing but the adenine containing nucleotide. So this is the anticodon, because whatever this sequence is present on this tRNA molecule, it is against this sequence or against the sequence of codon present on this mRNA molecule. So this is, and here there is a sequence of these amino acids, that is methionine, serine, leucine, lysine and arginine. Now this is the glycine, because this is called as the amino acid binding site here. Okay, that is present on the transfer RNA or tRNA molecule. So the pathway of this protein synthesis, it is called as the translation, because whatever that transcription process takes place, and in that transcription there is a mRNA molecule is formed, and according to the mRNA molecule or the information copied in mRNA molecule, that protein will be formed. So this pathway of protein formation or protein synthesis, that is called as translation. And the language of that nucleotide sequence which is present on this mRNA molecule, that is called as the genetic code. So this is the genetic code, or it is called as code language. Okay, and according to this code language, there is a synthesis of protein takes place, which is called as translation process. So the next point we will see about genetic code. So as I have told earlier in previous slide, that letters, or these, we can see these are the single letters of that nucleotides or that nitrogen bases here. This A stands for adenine, guanine, thymine and cytosine. And these A, Z, T and C, they correspond to the nucleotides present in the DNA molecule. And all these nucleotides present in that mRNA molecule, they are organized in the form of codons. That is the collection of three letters here, as we have seen in the previous slide, or we can see here. Okay, so the collection of this codon, it is called as the genetic code. See, this is the genetic code here. Now this is the DNA molecule, double-stranded DNA molecule, and if you enlarge this portion of that DNA molecule, so that will shows here such type of sequence, that is adenine, thymine, guanine, cytosine, then thymine, adenine, guanine and cytosine. So that is, that codon means here it is the collection of three nucleotides. For example, on the DNA molecule, if there is a ATG, now whatever that information is copied here, on mRNA molecule there will be adenine, so there will be uracil, then there will be adenine and there will be cytosine, because thymine is not present in the mRNA molecule or RNA molecule. So that's why the sequence will be and against of this sequence here, complementary to this one. Okay, so for near about, because all of you know that proteins are made up of 20 amino acids, and therefore for 20 amino acids there should be 20 codons, and each codon, they should have three nucleotides. So each codon, it consists of three nucleotides, and that is gives the specificity to each of the amino acid of a specific codon. It means one codon is responsible for one amino acid. So if you see that nucleotides, one nucleotide, then there is a four combinations will be there. If you consider two nucleotides, there will be 16 combinations. Then if there are three nucleotides, there will be 64 combinations, and these are the most suited for that different 20 amino acids. Okay, so this genetic code, it is a dictionary that corresponds with sequence of nucleotides and sequence of amino acids, because whatever that codon is present on that mRNA molecule, according to that codon, that protein will be present in the, that amino acid will be present in the protein molecule, and the words in dictionary are in the form of codons. So genetic code is one type of dictionary, for example. And the words in that dictionary, these are present in the form of codons. And each codon, as I told earlier, it is a triplet of nucleotides. It means each codon consists of three nucleotides, and there are 64 codons are present, and three out of that 64 codons, these are called as nonsense codons, or these are called as termination codons, because these three codons out of 64, they does not specify any amino acid, or they does not code for any amino acid. That's why these are called as nonsense codons. Or when such codon is occur in that mRNA molecule, then that translation process stops, or that translation process terminates. So that's why these three nonsense codons, these are also called as termination codons. So out of this 64 codons, now 3 are nonsense codons, they does not specify any amino acids, and the remaining 61 codons, they code for 20 different amino acids, which are responsible for the making of all protein molecules. Okay, so this is the again introduction of the genetic code. Now see, this is the genetic code table. Now we know that codon, it is made up of 3 nucleotides. See, this is the first letter here, these are the first letter of the codon, this is the second letter of the codon, and this is the third letter of the codon. And I already told you that one codon, or that codons, these are responsible for the specification of amino acid in the protein molecule. So whatever that protein molecule will be formed here, or whatever the sequence of that amino acid will be there, that will be according to the codons present in that mRNA molecule. So if the first letter of that codon is U, second letter of codon is U, and third letter of codon is U, so the codon will be UUU, and this codon, it specifies the amino acid phenylalanine. Okay, so here UUC, if the first letter will be U, second letter will be U, and if the third letter will be C of that codon, then that codon will become UUC, and the amino acid specified by this codon, it will be again same phenylalanine. Okay, so this is the genetic code table. So if you see this table here, you will observe that these different types of codons, these are responsible for the amino acid, that protein synthesis, or one codon specifies one amino acid, or there are many amino acids are there which are specified by more than one codon. Okay, so here now these codons are there, UAA, UAG, and this that UGA. These are called as stop codons, these are called as termination codons, or these are known as nonsense codons, because they does not specify any amino acid. Okay, so here another one codon is here, AUG, which specifies this methionine amino acid. This AUG, it is called as the start codon, because this codon is responsible for the initiation of protein synthesis. So that's why it is called as the start codon. So this is about the genetic code table. Now we will see the properties of genetic code, or the characteristics of genetic code. The first characteristics, or the first property of genetic code, is specificity. It means that genetic code is specific. That means again, a specific codon always codes for the same amino acids. So it means that codon is specific, or it is also called as that codon is unambiguous. For example, here this codon UUU, it codes for the amino acid phenylalanine. It cannot code for any other amino acid. Okay, so it means that codon is specific. We can say here this UUU codon, it is specific for this phenylalanine amino acid. So this is called as the specificity of codon, or it means that codon is unambiguous. So this is the one property. The second property is these codons are universal. It means in all living organisms that genetic code is the same. For example, if you are, suppose that example here, in case of any living organism, for example, in case of human, just we will take example here, UUU, it codes for the phenylalanine, and this same codon, when it is present in the animal, for example, so in that animal also, that will codes for the phenylalanine. For example, living organism changes, that amino acid cannot changes here. So whatever the genetic code is present, or if it is specifying, for example, phenylalanine in human, then same codon will, if present in animal, so in that animal also, it will specifies for phenylalanine. That means it is universal. But the exception is to universality is present in the mitochondrial codons, where this AUA codon, it codes for methionine, and UGA codon, it codes for tryptophan instead of isoleucine and termination codons respectively for cytoplasmic protein synthesizing machinery. Because this, if that codons, mitochondrial codons, if they are present in mitochondria, for example, this AUA and UGA, then they will specify methionine and tryptophan respectively. But in case of other, or in case of that another codons here, or in cytoplasmic proteins, so these codons, they will specify these another amino acids, this AUA, it will specify isoleucine, and this UGA, it does not specify any amino acid, that is, it is a termination codon. And another exception is here AGA and AZZ, they code for arginine in cytoplasm, but in mitochondria, these are called as the termination codons. So this is the exceptions for the universality of the genetic code. So this is about the second property of genetic code. Then third property is redundancy, or that genetic code is redundant. It means it is degenerate. Degenerate means here, so although each codon, it corresponds to a single amino acid, every codon it corresponds or it specifies a single amino acid, but a single amino acid, it can be specified by many codons, or it has multiple codons, except tryptophan and methionine. Each amino acid has the multiple codons. For example, if you see this phenylalanine, so UUU and UUC. Now this phenylalanine, it is actually a single amino acid, but it is specified by more than one codon, because these two codons are responsible for the phenylalanine. If you see this serine amino acid, so these four codons are there which specify this same amino acid. So it means here a single amino acid, it can have a multiple codons. So here this is serine is a single amino acid, but it has multiple codons. So here there are four codons are there, and all of these four codons, they specify a single amino acid, that is called as serine. Okay, so there are so many examples are here. This threonine is there, it is specified by four of these codons. Then here that aspargine is there, it is specified by AAU and AAC. It means the single amino acid, it has multiple codons. So this such type of characteristics or property of that genetic code, it is called as the redundancy, or it is, that means that codes are degenerate, or that codons are degenerate, or this is the degeneracy of the codons. Okay, this is the next property. Now next one is that genetic code is non-overlapping and non-punctuated. What is the meaning of this non-overlapping and non-punctuated? See, all codons are interdependent, that is independent sets of three bases. Whatever these codons are here, so all of these codons are made up of three nucleotides. So these are the three bases are present here, three nucleotides are present here, and there is no overlapping. So codon is read from a fixed starting point as a continuous sequence of bases taken three at a time. If you want to read that codon here, you have to read that three nucleotides. So that is the codon, and the starting point is extremely important, and this is called as the reading frame. So that starting point, it is called as the reading. Okay, so reading, it is called as reading frame. Now so this is about the that it is, it means it is a non-overlapping and that are non-punctuated. That means that codons, these are commaless, because there is no any punctuation, there is no any comma between that codons or that nucleotides here. So it means it is non-punctuated. Next one is here, nonsense codons. So there are three codons, as I told earlier, there are three codons out of 64 in this genetic code dictionary, and it does not encode, it does not specify any amino acid. These are called as the nonsense codons, or these are also called as termination codons, or these are called as stop codons. So these termination codons or stop codons or nonsense codons, these are three in the genetic code, and that includes one is the UAA, another one is the UAG, and another one is the UGA. So these three codons are called as stop codons, because they stop the translation process or they stop the protein synthesis when they comes in the messenger RNA molecule. Okay, or these are called as termination codon because they terminate the protein synthesis, and these are called as nonsense codons because they does not specify any amino acid. Don't take the real meaning of this nonsense. So nonsense means here it is nothing but they does not specify any amino acid. So that's why these are called as nonsense codons. Okay, so this is nothing but the nonsense codons. Now initiator codon, or which is called as start codon. So as I told earlier here that AUG, it is the initiator codon in many of proteins, or it is the start codon. Because why it is called as start codon? Because when this AUG codon comes in the mRNA molecule, from that codon there is a initiation of that protein synthesis takes place, or there is a starting of that protein synthesis takes place. So that's why it is called as the initiator codon, or it is known as start codon. And in some cases that GUG, it is the initiator codon or it is the start codon. And the amino acid which is specified by this start codon or by this AUG, it is a methionine amino acid. So in many proteins the first amino acid will be here methionine, because it is specified by the start codon, and the start codon is AUG. Okay, so this is about the initiator codon. So friends, here we have studied about the different genetic properties of the that codons or genetic code, or the characteristics of the genetic code, and hope all of you got this point, that is about the gene expression, what is meant by molecular biology, then what is meant by genetic code, and which are the different properties of the genetic code. Okay, so friends, so again I am telling here, if you have not subscribed this channel, so kindly subscribe this channel, so you will get notifications of upcoming videos. Okay, so thank you, keep watching this Microbiology by Santosh Napte. Thank you.